Now we learn how to connect application board with XPO 8085 Anshuman trainer kit. This is our XPO 8085 trainer kit. This is our traffic light application board. Now you already connected the backside cable and power supply. Then through 26 pin FRC connector, we connect application board to XPO 8085 kit. All application board is connected to the lower port. Already program written in lower port. If you want to connect on upper port, you can change the port address in program and connect to the upper port. Now you can see I connected the traffic light board 8085 at lower port. Traffic light board is working on only 5 volt, so you don't need any external power supply for this application board. If you are using stepper motor, DC motor, ADDA1 and ADC DAC card, at that time you require the plus minus 12 volt. In that case you can connect this 4 pin relayment power supply. Every application board, we provide you 2 manuals, instructor guide, in which we provide you the assembly language program with opcode. Second is student workbook. In here we give the hardware information about the application board. Now you can open, these are the programs. You can see first the table we provide to you. Either you can write down the program directly in XPO 8085 kit, okay, or you can move the program which is already available in EEPROM. Now I just move the program and show to the one program to you. And here if you see accessories, these are the accessories, ADC, temperature control, and these are the name of the hex files. If you connected to the PC and if you want to download the file directly from PC to kit, at the time you can download these hex files. Okay, here you can see traffic light controller, input, swap, traffic light flashing. These are the 4 experiments and these are the respective hex files. Here you can see the execution's address. Okay, first we can move the programs. These are the E300, EFFF and 7000. When you move the programs from EEPROM to RAM, all these applications board program available in the respective locations. So first we show to you how to move the program. Switch on the kit. When you switch on the kit, you can see the Anshuman. If you don't see, you can press the reset button. Okay, now first we move the program. For that press M on keyboard. You can see move, then press enter, block, press enter, start location, type E300, press enter, end address EFFF, enter, 7000. All application board programs come into the RAM. Now I want to execute one program like flashing, okay, and the flashing program address is 7700. So execution procedure is, now press G, enter, enter, starting address of the program is 7700. You can observe the flashing program on traffic light card. All yellows are flashing, then green. In this program all red are on. After that all yellow are on, after that all green are on. So the continuous program will be run. So this is a sample program. Respective program similarly you can reset and execute one by one program. In inout program you have to connect, these are the port A, 8 pins, and the respective data you have to given in port A. When you execute the port A program, inout program, then the respective data will become on the port B, which is you can observe on the LED also, or you can measure on the DMM. Okay, for how to give the data, so if you see here, these are the VCC pins, okay, and these are the ground pins, means you can give the data from either VCC or either ground. Here in swap, whatever the data you given in the program port A, the result will be swapped and it observed on the port B. That is the swap program. And in traffic light program, you can see these are the two squares we provide to you. This is the first square, this is the second square. So one by one LEDs will be glows and you can observe the traffic light program. Thank you.